Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you how to know if you should cut ties with your ex going forward. Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great life to be.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract the kind of man you want as a direct result of stepping into the most alive and the most feminine version of you, without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or tricks. Now, many women today have a relationship with their exes, and in general, there's nothing inherently right or inherently wrong about maintaining a relationship with an ex. Here's the situation. I'm gonna give you some ideas about, some specifics about the situation. And if you find yourself that these things are true for you, then my advice under these circumstances is that you cut ties with him. Why? Because otherwise it's going to mess up your life. So let me share the concept with you first. If your ex is someone who is not good for you as a partner, he's proven to not be reliable, he's proven to not be respectful, he's proven to not be the kind of person who lifts you up and who helps you step into a better version of you, then that's one strong consideration against continuing to see him. But here's where it comes worse. If that's the case, if the guy is not good for you as a partner, or it could be and or, you still have strong feelings towards him, and he still has strong feelings towards you. You know you shouldn't be back with him, but you still have feelings for each other, that is a strong stop seeing him sign. Why? Because the likelihood that your brain will trick you into thinking that you're just doing this for friendship and that it has no negative impact on your life is high. The reality is that it has a negative impact on your life because those three things. Number one, it decreases your hunger to go out and find someone who's a true match for you. So long as you have this guy who's kind of quasi-filling the role of a quasi-boyfriend, right? Surrogate boyfriend, then what happens is you don't feel the punch me in the stomach type pain that allows you to say, I'm going to find something that is meaningful and fulfilling. You can get just enough not to have to get up and do something about it. Number two, because it's going to create confusion. Why? Because part of you is going to start asking the question, well, if he really loved me, why is he not connecting with me right now? Can we make this thing work again? Now, these are going to be thoughts that have nothing to do with reality sometimes, but the act of being with someone in close proximity, time and time again, will make you deceive yourself into thinking that it's possible when you full well know that it's not possible. Don't do this to yourself. And the last one is time. Why? Because it's going to grab that vision of the future that you have, that possibility of a new guy who wants you, who's more compatible with you to come into your timeline, and it's gonna push it away indefinitely. Why? Because your heart will still be craving for this to happen. Even if you intellectually know it's not good for you, emotionally, you're getting your needs met through this uncomfortable and unfortunate situation. So my best advice for you is, and I'll recap this for you, if the guy that you were with is not good for you as a partner, you have feelings for him, he has feelings for you, cut the umbilical cord once and for all, pull the plug, take off the band-aid, whatever metaphor you want to use, once and for all. Instead of doing it in bits and pieces, say, right now, I really like you as a human being. I may even love you as a human being. We're not good with each other. And I know that if I continue connecting with you, I'm going to A, lower my hunger to get what I really want, B, waste your time, C, potentially do something that I will regret later. So for those reasons, and at least from now until the foreseeable future, we cannot be friends. Stop telling yourself you can be friends with someone you're super attracted to, they're super attracted with you, and they're not good for you. It can't happen, at least for right now. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful to you in some way. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do three things, my dear. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel, and if you click on the little bell next to the subscription button, you'll be able to be notified of new episodes as they come out. Number three, most important of all, if you feel like you want to get a better understanding, better, more profound understanding as to how you can enter the relationship that you want, there will be a link on the first line of the description of this video that will allow you to click on it, enter your name and email, and be taken right away to a 40-minute masterclass that I created for you on the subject, and it's absolutely free. If you're saying to yourself, Bern, I love what you're sharing with me, and videos, quite honestly, don't cut it for me. I need more than videos. I need hand-holding, I need accountability, I need strategy, and I need a customized plan that works for my specific situation. There's a second link on the description of this video that you can click on it, apply to work with me. If I feel I can help you, I'll read every application personally. My assistant will reach out and set up a time for us to connect. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.